Hello everyone, today I want to do a little bit of a ramble on about vinyl and valves and hums and hisses and buzzes and things. And my first topic today is going to be new vinyl. Now, this is new, brand new. I bought this in New York, just come off the press, if you get what I mean, no pun intended. Magical Mystery Tour, The Beatles. It was either this or Paranoid by Black Sabbath. But I bought this instead, seeing as I've already got Paranoid by Black Sabbath. And it sounds very rich and mellow. Now, I have the Beatles Anthology set on CD. And it's got Strawberry Fields Forever on it. And, yeah, sounds lovely. Beatles. When you play it on a CD player, I've played it on a CD player through this Sony. Yeah, sounds nice, everything. But until I played this, I've not heard Strawberry Fields Forever. On vinyl, it sounds so mellow, so rich and deep and warm. And I can vouch that vinyl is so much better than CD in every single way. Let me take you down, 'cause I'm going to Strawberry Field. Nothing is real. Right Nazis to get me, but the point remains that vinyl is much more warmer and has got much more of a depth and a richness to it than the humble CD. This is just a cheap KTEL one, but the point remains, CDs, crap. Now, another thing as well is about DVDs. DVDs are blighted with problems. Now, I bought this on my own money. I've got a lot of vintage comedy box sets. But I've got to tell you, this is the worst one. One Foot in the Grave. Episodes are brilliant. But the quality of the DVDs, nice. But they always break up and everything. Brand new DVDs break up, so I don't know how that works out. Now if these were on video, they'd be excellent. If they were on come on, good old fashioned Betamax, no doubt that they would last forever, because Betamax is so, come on, get out, because Betamax is superior to everything except maybe U-matic, which is basically Betamax. But other than that, yeah, another thing as well is I'm a subscriber to What HiFi and other HiFi magazines, and the stuff I read in them makes me cringe. They say spend 50 quid on leads, gold plated ones. To be honest with you, they don't improve the sound at all. I got a few second-hand ones off my grandfather, who was getting rid of them, and don't make a difference at all. I find them just too clumsy. I mean, they're about that thick. And in one of Badeditpro's videos, when he said they're very good for renewing line outputs on record players, that's what I use them for. But it still remains as well that The quality just isn't there. And also these silly little modern turntables where you've got the platter here and a motor and like a white belt that comes around the outside and a motor here. Of course, that belt's going to just rumble and noise. Now, if I put my microphone towards here, you can hear nothing because it's direct drive. And my advice to anyone is just get yourself a 1980s direct drive turntable, either Technics, Sony, Pioneer, JVC, whatever. Because These modern, as JC would call them, foo-foo turntables don't have the quality either. I mean, on some of them, you have to take the platter off and put the belt on the pulley to change the speed. I mean, on the, you've just got a simple speed adjuster. But it remains as well, these were some of the finest turntables ever made. Sony PSLX LX ranges, ranging from 2 to 4, because of course they've got servo lock, Technics and quartz lock. I've had experience with Technics, turntables in the past. My granddad's got one, a brand new one. My granddad's a bit of an audiophile as well. He paid about £400 for his Technics turntable with the long blue stylus. That sounds absolutely beautiful. And he said, oh, my Technics sounds great, hooked up to me dead and amplifier. I said, it does, yeah. And I invited him round. I said, I put this on. He went, oh no, Sony. Sony tuning. Oh. Played it. He went, oh, it sounds really nice, actually. He said, I wish I'd bought my Technics now. I wish I'd just bought one of these. I said, well, the point remains. I mean, for playing your 45s, say like this, if you're playing 1960s 45s that, oh god, aren't too well, I would advise not playing them on this machine. 1970s and 80s ones in good condition, yeah, sound nice. But 60s and 50s 45s, no, I advised against that really. I don't play 45s on this machine, 60s ones. My Russ Conway ones are in good condition, I'll play them, but I might wrap this video up because it's nearly getting to 7 minutes and my memory card's getting full. Sorry everyone, I've got to do this on my crappy camera. But the SD card for my other one is gone walkabouts. So, to hear us out with the Beatles, we're going to have a little bit of All You Need Is Love. If I can hit the right spot, which I probably can't. Whoops. Oh, I can.